You there. Just you wait.
Hey, Robinson. Come down.
Here, it's for you.
Alone today on my desert island, I would be so happy to hear his pompous lectures. But I was much too proud to bother learning anything at all. And now that I must depend on myself, I realize I know nothing. Nothing. I don't even know how to resharpen my broken knife on a stone. Alas, I have all the time I need to practice. Sparks. But if I can make sparks, I can make fire. Fire. With some fire, I'm saved. I'll be able to keep a watch fire going day and night. Sooner or later, a ship will pass and rescue me. After that, I swear I'll never be tempted to voyage again. I'll enjoy life peacefully, even if I have to be a lawyer's assistant for the rest of my days. In order to produce a flame, the spark must fall on something dry, very dry. But nothing I find is dry enough. I did have a few shreds of tobacco, but I ate them for breakfast. I'd give 10 years of my life for tinder. But why not use the braid on my coat as tinder? This will teach me never to give up hope. If I hadn't broken my knife, I would never have thought of using it as a flint. Eggs? Shellfish? Water? Fire. Perhaps I have a chance of surviving until I'm rescued. Thank you. Back home in England, we soft boil our eggs. Here, I bake them in ashes. As I've never cooked before, anything can happen. I hope they won't explode in my face. They're excellent. I may turn into quite a cook. I'll need a weapon to hunt any game that might be on the island. This bamboo stick is both simple and effective. Unfortunately, the point bends too easily. I'll try to harden it in the fire. I read an adventure story where this method was used. However, I don't recommend it. When you put wood into a fire, it burns. Despite my ignorance of zoology, I don't believe these footprints are those of a jaguar or a puma. They look more like footprints of wild goats. What trouble I had fastening my knife to the bamboo stick. All that work made me so hungry I could eat a lion. I was right. There are goats here. Oh, I can already smell the roast cooking. Like I have an orphan on my hands. What'll happen to it without its mother's milk? Of course, I'll take care of it, but I have no idea how to raise a baby goat. Maybe the sun is bad for him. To play safe, I'll put him in the shade. I'll tie his feet to keep him from doing anything foolish. Above all, he mustn't run away. I need a companion too much. He's the first living creature I've met here I can talk to. My conscience and natural disgust prevent me from eating my friend. However, on the island there must be flesh eaters who have no reason to share my noble sentiments, and some who might even be capable of eating the stepfather along with the orphan. I don't have time to build a shelter before nightfall. Only, how do you keep a goat in a baobab tree? Fortunately, there are some plane trees on the island whose leaves are easy to knot and braid into a rope. In Brazil, I saw them put to 1,000 uses. To make baskets, thatched roofs for huts, and even clothes. As the stems made a thread that could be woven into cloth. But I'm not that ambitious. For what I have in mind, all I have to do is soak the stems in water to make them more pliable. In this hammock, my goat can sleep next to me. He'll be the first goat in the history of the world to sleep up in a baobab tree. doesn't the poor animal appreciate the honor, but his little body is trembling with fear. Tomorrow I'll see about feeding you. I wonder what a goat dreams about. As for me, if I must dream, I might as well dream about the most beautiful day of my life, when I boarded Captain Darrick's ship. That day, I thought the whole world belonged to me.